covering northeastern and central Pennsylvania and everywhere you are. This is Eyewitness News at 11 in high definition.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Candace Kelly.
And I'm Drew Spire. Thank you for joining us tonight. A very busy day in the Jerry Sandusky child sex abuse trial. With the prosecution resting, the defense is now building its case. Today, they called two former Penn State football coaches to the stand.
And those coaches testified that it was not uncommon for coaches to shower with young children following workouts. Our lead I-Team reporter, Andy Mahalshik, has more from Bellefonte.
The jury could get this case by Thursday, but the question tonight remains this. Will Jerry Sandusky testify in this trial?
Defense attorneys are trying to show that Jerry Sandusky is no monster, that despite allegations of being a serial child predator, he is anything but. On Monday, the defense called six witnesses. The most impactful, if not eye-opening, testimony was from former Penn State coach Richard Anderson. He was an offensive coordinator and worked with Sandusky for decades. He was also a close personal friend. He told the jury that it was not unusual to see Penn State coaches in the showers with young boys who may have been on campus for a variety of reasons. Anderson said it was part of the lifestyle. There was nothing dirty about it. He said, "Yes, I saw him shower with young boys. I showered with young boys at the YMCA. It's not unusual. It's a part of life at Penn State to shower after workouts." The prosecutor, "Do you hug them in the shower?" Anderson, "No." "Did you bring them to the shower?" Anderson, "No." The defense has been arguing that many of the alleged victims have hired lawyers to make money, to gain financially from the Sandusky scandal. Attorney Tom Klein represents alleged victim number 5. In fact, he was served a subpoena by the defense outside the courthouse. He was instructed to bring records detailing his contact with alleged victims and the news media, and he may be called to testify by the defense. He says the defense theory of alleged victims cashing in is simply ridiculous.
The defense has never asked the question to one witness, do you have an intention to file a civil claim for monetary damages? That question would be probative as to what these young men might seek in the future and how their testimony might be colored.
Once again, the jury could get this case by Thursday. Reporting in Bellefonte, Sarah County, Andy Mahalshik, Eyewitness News.
And for continuing coverage of the Jerry Sandusky child sex abuse trial, go to pahomepage.com.